this video, we want to break down Ali Abdaal's style. Why? Because his style can create great engagement with your audience. If you want to create your personal page, or if your client says,
"I want the same style as him,"
then this video is for you, my friend. I will explain all of his style in 5 steps. Step 1. Why are his videos different? The first thing is he puts his camera at eye level. We have 3 angles for shooting video: high angle, low angle, and eye level. Let me explain them to you. High angle. This is when the camera is positioned above the subject, making them appear smaller or weaker. Low angle. A shot from below the subject, giving them a powerful or dominant look. Eye level. The camera is at the subject's eye height, making viewers feel close and connected to them. And when he sits in front of the camera, he sits close, so you feel very close to him. You may not notice this, but it's important in social media to make viewers feel more comfortable and closer to you. Before we go on, make sure to like the video, subscribe, and hit the bell icon to stay tuned for new CapCut tutorials. Step 2. How to create a hook like Ali. Usually, his hooks are about 2 seconds long. He says something or asks a question based on his book, and after that, he shows you a collage-style animation. Let's break down some of his hook styles. Let me open CapCut. So imagine he said his sentence. Add his video to the timeline and duplicate it. Select the second layer. On the right side, go to Remove Background and use Auto Removal. You can add a stroke effect if you want, but let's save that for another tutorial. Create a keyframe at the beginning of the video for position. Then move a little further along and lower him slightly. Right-click on it, choose Show Keyframe Animation, select the second keyframe, and use Auto Curve. Drag it to the left to make the movement smoother. Now hide the Show Keyframe option. Press Ctrl plus C to copy the layer. Right-click on the first layer and choose Paste Attributes, but remember to uncheck Auto Remove, since we don't want to remove the background again. As you can see, both layers now move down. Now add a background with motion and duplicate it. Select both layers and create a compound clip. On the right side, go to the mask option and choose a horizontal mask. Rotate it slightly, then create a keyframe on position. Move the playhead to the beginning of the timeline and push it up. Now, you'll have something like this. To improve it, sync the animation timing with Ali's movement. Use Auto Curve like you did with his layers. As you can see, Ali moves with a slight delay, so move the first keyframe to the right side. Now both animations are synced. Finally, you can add your title or icons here. As we are editors, we all want to learn new things and improve our craft. So, if you're looking to improve your storytelling or boost your creativity, both of which are essential for video editing, then SkillShare is the perfect platform for you. It's the biggest online learning community for creatives, offering classes on everything from illustration, productivity, photography, logo designing, to music. As a YouTuber, I'm always looking to improve my skills in scripting and everything that goes into making better content. I found out that Marques, or as you might know him from his channel MKBHD, has a course where he shows how he scripts and creates his videos. Since he's such a successful YouTuber, what better way to learn than from one of the best? Joining his class was great. It helped me learn how to find the best ideas, improve my editing, and create even better content. SkillShare has thousands of classes for all levels, helping you go from beginner to pro in no time. These classes are taught by experts who share their tips and tricks, and you can even create your own projects and get feedback from other members. Right now, SkillShare is all about learning and growing this fall, making it the perfect time to start something new. You can learn at your own pace with on-demand classes. And here's something cool. The first 500 people who use my link in the description will get a free 1-month trial. So, click on the first link in my description and let SkillShare help you take your skills to the next level. So thank you, SkillShare, for sponsoring this video. Third step. What's collage animation? Collage animations are cutout photos of people, animals, objects, tools, and everything. If you really like collage animation, I have a package of his style. I'll put the link in the description, and you can download it. For example, if you have a travel video, you need to put your images at the center like this. Then add a yellow circle at the center. The easiest way is to add a default text layer. Then press the Windows key and the dot key on your keyboard to open this window. And now you can choose any shape you want. You can scale it, change the color, and adjust other things as you like. Now you can add a bird image, backpack, tree, or any image related to your topic. And for adding random movements, you should create them as compound clips separately. And use the play pendulum effect. Set the twist to 0, strength to 10 or lower, sharpen to 10, and speed to 50 or 100. Apply these settings to other layers too, but with different numbers to get random movements. And finally, you'll get something like this. You always see a flower in his videos because it represents his personality. So if you want to create your page and use this style, make sure to add personal elements in your videos too. Can you guess my personality symbol? Step 4. How do we add texture to our videos? In his B-roll, we always see a texture like dotted lines. Some of them are barely visible. This texture helps show you're watching a B-roll video, separating these shots from others. I found some of these textures for you, and I'll put them in the description. How do we add texture to our videos? Just add the image on top of your timeline, then scale it. And on right side, change blend mode to multiply. Don't use screen because you get something like this. And as you can see, we can't see his face very good. So reduce opacity to 15 or 20. Step 5. What font does he use? He uses two fonts in his videos. One of them is a normal font, but the second one is important, the handwriting font. It feels more personal, like someone wrote it on screen, and everyone can read it. Okay, let's recreate this shot and show you how he uses it. We should duplicate the video layer. Select the second one, go to the right side and remove the background. Now put any color image between the layers. Then use a fade-in animation. Increase duration for in animation to get slower fade-in. For animating Ali, you can do it manually or use slide-down animation. Both can do the job. For handwriting text, you can use CapCut's fonts, but I wasn't sure which one matched his style, so I downloaded some fonts from Google. You can check the link in the description for those. Choose the yellow color, then scroll down and turn on the glow option. Oh wait, what the? I think we have a bug. Let me restart it. Let me try again. Now it's good. Use my settings. I just write some random text for this part. Once you choose your favorite handwriting font, make sure to highlight the important words. For example, don't forget to like, comment, support, and happy. Choose the type 1 animation. And for random movements, use the jiggle loop animation. The problem is that when the type animation finishes, the jiggle animation starts, causing a noticeable jump. Your client might not notice it, but I don't like that jump, so I just wanted to let you know. Next, add the stickers to the timeline. And using the chroma key option, select the green area to remove the green screen. After that, place all the layers under the Ali video layer, and you're done. That was all for his style. If you want to learn how to edit like by Maximize on CapCut, so click on this video. And remember, as always, stay creative.